And hello everyone, welcome back to a new video. And finally, after a long time, I have decided to make an update video on my A46. It's been a very long time since I've last made this kind of video where I've showcased you guys my car. But we got a little bit of a twist this time. I haven't done a single video on the A46 this year because, well, there hasn't been a lot of changes done to the car, and because of that I didn't really film the car. But this time we have quite a long list of differences in the A46, and it's got a little bit of a twist, and you're about to see every single bit of details about that. Just wait a little second, because it's going to be quite different. Voila! As you can tell, for those who are not new to the channel, you can tell that this is not my old E46, this is a new one. It's a coupe. So yeah, I sold my old car and I picked this one up. I basically bought what I always wanted to buy. I wanted to buy a coupe in the first place, but you know, stars didn't align, and basically I didn't end up with an E46 as my E46 coupe as my first car. But here we have it. I just washed it up, so it's still wet. But yeah, basically I have sold an E46 so I can buy an E46. To be more specific, I sold a 2-liter diesel E46 so I can buy a 2-liter diesel E46. Stupid ass. Anyway. So yeah, it's a 2-liter diesel, 150 horsepower, okay? So it's a little bit more powerful than the previous car, but you know, not by much. And yeah, we're gonna get into it a little bit, but let's mention a little one change that was even on the old car, which you haven't seen a single time, and that's the wheels. I got Style 66s for my winter set. These are from the E39 M Sport. They are squared setup, 8J ET20 all around. They look absolutely amazing. I love this set of wheels. This is like pretty much one of my favorite possible sets of wheels for a winter set. I think they are absolutely perfect. Damn, I just washed the car, it's still dirty. That shit is ridiculous. Anyways, I got my dream interior as well. Natural brown leather, it's absolutely amazing. I love this interior so freaking much. But yeah, let's just get into it a little bit because it's cold as fuck outside. Woo, here we are in the new E46. So let's talk about why I have decided to, you know, sell my old car. You know, break the rule number one, never sell your first car, which, you know, well, I've done it. But let's talk about why I have done this, and to get you to understand the situation a little bit. So this used to be my friend's car for the past year, and before he even bought it, I was really, really close to buying it myself, because I was like 100% ready to put my car for sale and to go and buy this exact car. But you know, because of the amounts of money that I had to decide, that wasn't really possible. So my friend ended up buying this car. He got very easily tired of it, bored of it, because it's relatively slow. I mean, it is very slow. 150 horsepower is nothing these days, and he went from a 300 horsepower Golf GTI to this car, so he got bored straight away, you know. But you know, I wanted this car always, and I didn't have a problem with my old E46. I loved that car. I didn't really care about upgrading that much, but I was like, this car has every single thing that I wanted in my old E46, and for not much more money I get a lot more car. So this car is fully loaded. I mean, it's got, I mean, you probably saw already, but it's got electric seats, it's got heated seats, lumbar support as well, which is very rare in E46s. It doesn't have a Harman-Kardon system, but it's got hi-fi system, which is still an upgrade. It's got the TPMS sensor, it's got the rear power sunshade, which, I mean, I had a sunshade before, but
There we go.
As you can see. I mean, I had a sunshade as well, but it wasn't power fold. Then this car also has a rain sensor. It's got the sunroof. Sunroof is something that I always wanted to have in my car. Also got power folding mirrors. It's got AFL headlights, which is also extremely rare in these cars. AFL headlights are adaptive headlights. It's also got, I don't know, it's got a lot of fucking stuff. And also, I mean, this interior is, like I said briefly a couple of seconds ago, it's my dream interior. I've been looking for this interior ever since I bought my old car. I wanted to have this interior. So this thing has absolutely everything that I wanted my old car to have and has some benefits up on top of it. So for instance, my old car was a 318 diesel. This is a 320 diesel. Now, technically, they are very similar. They're both M47 engines. But the differences are quite big, actually. So my old car was remapped to 150 horsepower. This car has 150 horsepower, but stock. So that's a little bit of a benefit. So if I get this car remapped, it's going to get a decent amount more power than the previous car. But, you know, deep down, the engine is a lot different. Like, for instance, the camshaft is different. Turbo is different. Injectors are different. Brakes are different on the car. The transmission is different on the car. You know, my old car was a 5-speed. This is a 6-speed. But overall, even if this was a 5-speed, it would be a totally different transmission, because these ones are a lot more durable than the ones that were being put into a 318 for some reason. You know, it's got a lot of differences overall, and when you look at it, this makes for a better car, realistically, for someone like me. And it's a big upgrade in my mind, even though I've, you know, like I said, I went from an M47 E46 to an M47 E46, but maybe one day I can put an M57 in this car and make it the absolute dream E46, you know. But that's basically about it, you know. I just wanted to quickly showcase the car, tell you what's going on. Also, I got my dream first car, and last week I got my dream wheels as well. So I'll put a couple of photos on the screen right now. But basically, I managed to find CSL wheels fucking finally. I cannot express how long I've been waiting to get those wheels. And I've had a couple of sets run away from me really quickly. You know, they get sold in like a couple of hours. But finally, I got a set of 19s. They are not original OEM CSL wheels, because they are like $2,000 or something. I got Avis, I don't know how you pronounce it, to be honest with you. But they are basically one-to-one copies of CSL wheels, and they're going to look absolutely insane at the car. So I cannot wait for spring. In about 2 weeks, I'm going to get this steering wheel rewrapped, because it is in a little bit of a rough condition. I don't know if I can focus on the steering wheel. Please focus. As you can see, it's just, you know, it's faded away. It's a little bit sticky on some places, and you know, it's just not in perfect condition. This also trim needs to be done. So I'm getting the steering wheel rewrapped in about 2 weeks, and we're gonna get a multimedia system in a couple of weeks as well, and stuff like that. You know, the car is gonna get a lot of work done to it, and I cannot wait to start working on it, to be honest with you. This car is bringing me the thrill again of, you know, having something nice. My old E46, genuinely, I got bored of it, I'm not going to lie. Even though, like I said, I didn't have a problem with the car, I still liked it, but I didn't have that thrill of, like, wanting to do more stuff to it. I was just kind of, like, bored of the same exact car. You know, I wanted something to change significantly, so I can enjoy the car properly again. And this car brought me that joy back, I will be totally honest with you. So, you know, there's gonna be a lot of stuff done to this car. I've kept both of my sets of wheels, you know, this which you just saw, the style 66 is also my style 135s, but the style 135s I have traded in for the CSLs. So I got two really nice sets of wheels. I kept my cooler work choice shifter as well. It's in my room, so I'm waiting, probably maybe in a week or maybe two, I'll get the cooler works short shifter fitted in this car, which is gonna make a huge difference in the driving characteristics with it. But that's about basically it. I mean, I don't have what else to say. that's pretty much it. Stay tuned. I will make some videos with the car. I don't know what exactly I will. Maybe like the typical updates, just like what I did with the previous car. But we'll see about that. Maybe I can get some other things filmed as well for this car, but that's about it. You know, I just wanted to showcase the car, to make at least one update video on, you know, IRL stuff on this channel, because like I said, I haven't done a single video this year. So yeah, that's basically it. You know, I hope you guys like the car. It's gonna look so much better very soon. I mean, you probably already can tell by the intro of the video, the car is not completely M package. It's got the M Sport front bumper, but it doesn't have the side skirts and the rear bumper. That's also going to be done on the car relatively soon. I'm guessing up until like summertime of next year, I guess. I'm not sure, because I got a lot of stuff going on right now, so I don't know if I'm going to be able to financially keep up with all those things, but we'll see. You know, that's not something that I'm rushing. I'm rushing with the steering wheel and the multimedia system. That's the two things that I'm really rushing with this car. But everything else, it's gonna take time. I don't care how long, but you know, it's just a question of time. So that's basically about it. Thanks guys for watching. I hope you like the car, and I'll catch you guys in another video very, very soon. Peace out.